Hello everyone. In this video session, I'm going to explain part 231 of Java for tester series, that is TreeSet. So what is TreeSet? TreeSet is a predefined class in Java, which is a child class of navigable set interface. I already covered this navigable set interface in the previous video, guys. And here, TreeSet is a child class of this navigable set interface. And it is a grandchild class of sorted set interface. Even the sorted set interface also I covered as part of one of the previous videos, guys. Okay. I covered navigable set already and sorted set also. Okay. So coming to the TreeSet, TreeSet is a predefined class in Java, which is a child class of the navigable set interface and grandchild class of sorted set interface. Let me show you visually. So this is a complete collections framework where we have the root interfaces as collection, map and other stuff. So if you expand this collection, you will get the child interfaces of this collection interface, that is list, set and queue. Expand this set interface, guys, you'll get this sorted set. Under sorted set, we have this navigable set. You already know all these things because I already covered this in the previous videos. Now when you expand this navigable set, then you will get the TreeSet, guys. Okay, so TreeSet is a child class of which interface? Navigable set interface. TreeSet is a child class of the navigable set interface and it is a grandchild class of this sorted set interface. TreeSet is a grandchild class of this which interface? Sorted set interface. Okay, grandchild. So what is the advantage of this TreeSet class, okay, for having this parent as navigable set interface and grandparent as sorted set interface? The only advantage that TreeSet will get is all the predefined methods of the sorted set and navigable set can be utilized by the object reference of this TreeSet. Okay, by creating an object for this TreeSet, we can utilize, okay, we can use the predefined methods of this parent navigable set interface and grandparents. That is sorted set interface related predefined methods also. Okay, parents navigable set interface predefined methods and grandparent, that is sorted set interface predefined methods. All these predefined methods we can utilize with the TreeSet. At same time, from the sorted set, this TreeSet will inherit some properties like sorting. Okay, there are different type of sortings. That is default sorting and customized sorting. All these sorting features will be inherited by this TreeSet. At same time, navigable set is intended for the navigation purpose. Okay, it has some specific methods specific to navigation related methods are there with the navigable set. Okay, all those predefined methods can be utilized by this TreeSet. Okay, so let's understand more about this TreeSet, guys. Okay, in order to understand this TreeSet, I have to explain about this sorted set, navigable set, and then I have to compare that with the TreeSet. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, so let's remove this part because we need more space. Here we have sorted set interface, guys. Okay, sorted set interface. In middle we have navigable set interface. Okay, and we can keep here TreeSet. TreeSet is a interface or class. It's a class which is a TreeSet is a predefined class which is a child class of the navigable set and grandchild of this sorted set, right? So now let's understand more by providing these lines here. So let's start with the sorted set. So coming to the sorted set interface, duplicates are allowed or not? Duplicate objects are allowed or not? Sorted set, okay, in sorted set, duplicate objects are not allowed, okay? Duplicate objects are not allowed in the sorted set. The same thing, okay, here also navigable set also same thing, duplicate objects are not allowed. This set is also child class of the sorted set. It also has the same property, that is duplicate objects are not allowed. Let's try that. Let's check with this set and see whether the duplicate objects are getting allowed or not. Okay, so for that, let's go to this Java program. Sample Java project is there. with the sample class and sample main method. Inside this main method, I'll write some logic for this tree set. Okay, I would like to show you. I can create an object for the tree set. I cannot create objects for the navigable set because navigable set is an interface. Same time, sorted set is also an interface. For interfaces, we cannot create objects in Java. So, but tree set, which is a child and grandchild of this navigable set and sorted set, can be created an object. Okay, we can create an object for the tree set. Let's try to create an object for the tree set. Preset. I will say t is equal to new preset. Okay. Hover the mouse on this preset and import this preset predefined class from the java.util package. After importing that, what we have to check, guys? What we have to check? We have to check whether preset allows duplicate objects or not. Let's try to do that. T dot add. Okay. T dot add. Let's try some integer objects, 9, then t dot add someone, then t dot add some 8. So far I didn't add any duplicate objects. If I print this, what are these objects? 9, 1, 8 are there. They will be printed. Okay. The objects added to the tree set will be printed. Okay. 9, 1 and 8 got printed. Fine. That's good. But what if I try to add a duplicate object here? Okay, so far there were no duplicate objects, but if I try to add a duplicate object like 9, okay, will I get a compiler error? No, you will not get any compiler error. But when I run this program, okay, this duplicate object will not be inserted into the tree set. Okay, you will not see the duplicate object in the tree set. Only this 3. Only once it will be added to the tree set, guys. Okay, even though it's not giving the compiler error, you will not get any compiler error, even though the object will not be inserted. You see, only the unique objects got added. 189. The duplicate object 9 didn't get added twice. Here only 19 is there. I'm expecting 2 nines. That will not be possible because the reason here is sorted set or navigable set or tree set doesn't allow the duplicate objects. Okay, doesn't allow the duplicate objects. You will not get the compiler error. But even after the inserting them, there will be no use. Okay, they will not be inserted into the tree set. They will be inserted only once. Unique objects will be inserted. If you try to insert the duplicate object, they will not be inserted. That's the one thing. Okay, that's cleared. Second thing we need to know here is sorted set. Is there any insertion order? If you insert some objects, in which order? If you insert some objects, will they be inserted in the same way they got inserted? For example, if you inserted some object 1, object 2, object 3, object 4. Will the same insertion order will be stored in the sorted set? No, guys. Insertion order is not at all compatible here. Okay, it's not applicable actually. So sorted set follows sorting order. Instead of we talking about insertion order, we have to talk about the sorting order. Okay, whatever the objects you are inserting, they will be sorted out. Okay, whatever the objects that are you are inserting into the sorted set, they will be sorted out. According to some sorting order, they will be sorted. Okay. So what type of sorting will be there? By default sorting order will be there. Okay. By default sorting order will be there. That means if you are inserting some integer objects, okay, like this. Let's say you have inserted some integer objects, right? 9, 1, 8. Okay. By default, these objects will be sorted. According to the sorting order of the sorted set, they will be sorted. And in which order they will be sorted? Default sorting order. For integers, the default sorting order is, for integer objects, the default sorting order is ascending order. Okay? Ascending order. The same thing will be followed by this tree set, guys. Tree set also does the same thing. Okay? Tree set, which is the grandchild of the sorted set, also follows the same sorting order that is followed by the sorted set. Okay, that means by default sorting order will be there, followed by this tree set. That means if you try to add different integer objects, let's say 9, 1, 8, 2, okay, whatever the objects you add of say 25, t dot add of 13, like this, different integer objects I added, right? Now if I print this tree set, in which order all these objects will be in, you have inserted the integer objects in this order. First 9 you have inserted, then 1, 8, 2, 25, 13, but they will be stored internally by this tree set in which order? Some sorting order, that is default sorting order. If you don't specify a particular sorting order, tree set will consider the default sorting order, which is nothing but for integer objects the default sorting order is ascending order. So ascending order, you know, right, in mathematics the least number, that is 1, will come first, then second, then it will store after 1 to 8 will be stored, then 9 will be stored, then 13 will be stored, then 25 will be stored. That is the ascending order. Let's see that whether we are getting an ascending order in the output or not. You see, 1, lowest number is 1, then after that we have 2, the next big number is 2, then next big number is 8, then next big number is 9, then next big number is 13, then next big number is 25. So this is ascending order. Default sorting order of the tree set for the integer objects is which sorting order, guys? Ascending order. Okay, so that is nothing but this ascending order. This has been inserted, this feature has been inherited by the tree set from which interface? Sorted set interface. Okay, as tree set is a child, grandchild class of the sorted set interface, this default sorting order has been inherited. Similarly, we get a doubt where, okay, what if these are not integer objects? If you got some string objects, okay, if you insert some string objects, in which order, how this default sorting order will behave with these string objects? Simple, guys, alphabetical order. You know about the alphabetical order, right? The same thing will be followed by tree set also. Okay, tree set, which is the grandchild of the sorted set, will also follow the same alphabetical order. Let's find it out. So here, instead of these objects, I'll add some names, or even alphabets also I can add as strings. Okay, so let's give some names, guys. So I will give some Varun here, Venkat, or you'll give some different names. Mahesh, okay, Mahesh, Chandu, Kishore, okay, Swapnesh. Here I am giving my name, that is Arun. Then T dot add of another name also I'll give, that is Tarun. Like this. Okay, so here I am inserted some string objects. So in which order you have inserted Varun first, then Mahesh, then Chandu, Kishore, Swapnesh, Arun and Tarun. But while these are getting stored into the tree set, they will be sorted out in which order? In the default sorting order. And default sorting order for the string objects is alphabetical order. Okay, so alphabetical order, Arun will come first, right? Then Chandu, like that. Okay, let's see which order they will be printed. You see, Arun, Chandu, then Kishore came, then Mahesh, Swapnesh, Tarun and Varun. Okay, this is a alphabetical order. A comes first in alphabets coming compared to the C, like that. Okay, so this is the default sorting order. And apart from this default sorting order, we have customized sorting order. Okay, customized sorting order. So if you don't specify anything inside this tree set constructor, okay, if you don't specify anything inside this tree set constructor, that will be considered as a empty constructor. Empty tree set constructor means default sorting order. Okay, empty constructor means default sorting order. For customized sorting order, we have to provide something inside this constructor. That thing I will not explain now, guys. Okay, I'll explain it later. So we also have this customized sorting order. If you don't want the default sorting order, then we'll go for the customized sorting order. For example, if you want this integer objects inserted into the this tree set to be in descending order, can you do with the default sorting order? No, it's not possible. You have to go for a customized sorting order. Same time, if you want to have this string objects, okay, not in a reverse alphabetical order, okay, will that be possible with this default sorting order? No, it's not possible. So we have to go for the customized sorting order. Okay, so how to implement this customized sorting order with this preset, I'll be explaining in the end of the session. Okay, at the end of the session I'll do that. Okay, So for now, let's understand this tree set more. Okay, now you got something like duplicate objects are not allowed. Sorting order is there in sorted set. Same time, tree set also duplicate objects are not allowed. But the same sorting set which is there in the sorted set interface is also with the tree set. You understood to that point. Okay, but coming to the navigable set, navigable set interface has something that sorted set doesn't have. That is, it has navigation related methods. Okay, there are some methods specific to this navigable set, okay, which are whose purpose is for navigation related methods. Okay, they will help you in navigating. Okay, navigating through the objects that are inserted into this tree set. Okay, for navigating through the objects which are inserted into the tree set, we need some methods. So that methods are only there with the navigable set interface, and they are not there with the sorted set interface. Okay, this navigation related methods which are specific to the navigable set are there in the navigable set interface only. Okay, as tree set is also child class of this navigable set, all these predefined methods of this navigable set can be utilized for navigation purpose by this tree set. Okay, that thing also, how to navigate and all those things, I will explain later in a practical way. Fine. For now, you understood the tree set at a high level. Okay, in comparison with the sorted set, navigable set, tree set is something like this. Along with this duplicate objects are not allowed and sorting order and all the stuff, tree set also has some other things to understand. Next thing that we need to understand about tree set is heterogeneous objects are not allowed. Okay, heterogeneous objects are not allowed. Why they are not allowed? You cannot sort them. What is the main purpose of tree set, guys? If you insert some objects into the tree set, they will be sorted. The output, they will be sorted. You see, here Arun came first. In alphabetical order, they got sorted. But if you have heterogeneous objects, string object, numerical object, and double object, boolean object, if you have such kind of heterogeneous objects, can we sort them? Is it possible to sort? That is the reason, guys, tree set doesn't allow you to insert heterogeneous objects. If you try to do so, what will happen? You will get a compiler error. Okay, so let's say instead of this string object, if I add some 9, you will not get compiler error, guys. Sorry, you will get runtime error. Okay, 3.52. And if I give some boolean value true here, okay, let's see what will happen now. Let's run this. Tree set will not be able to sort this heterogeneous objects, guys. That's the reason it will give you a runtime error. Okay, you see, runtime exception case. That is class cast exception. Okay, so you cannot have heterogeneous objects if you try to add the heterogeneous objects into the tree set, because heterogeneous objects cannot be sorted with the help of the tree set. We cannot sort the heterogeneous objects. That's why in the runtime you will get this kind of exception. Okay, in the runtime you will get the exception. That's the problem. So you should not be adding this heterogeneous objects into the tree set. Either you have to add the integer objects like this, all objects should be integer objects, or all objects should be string objects. Okay, all objects should be string objects. Okay, so another thing you need to understand, that is, all the objects that you insert here, for example, if you are inserting all the objects as some string objects, okay, let's move back. If you are inserting all the string objects, okay, so this string object, let's go to the string object. Let's search for in the API, Java 8 API, let's go for the string object. That is string class. Okay, it's not string object, string class. Let's find the string class in the API documentation of the Java 8. Control F and search for string. Simply search for the string class. Okay, so if you observe, string is a predefined class in Java and it has some implemented interfaces. One of the interfaces that string class is implementing, string implements interface, that kind of thing. Okay, that is comparable. As you can see, there is a comparable. String class is implementing the interface known as comparable. Okay, similarly, let's go to another one. That is, if you instead of string objects, if you give some integer values like this, okay, 9, 1, 7, 3, 25, 13, okay, 8. Will this be sorted, guys? Will this give any error? Any compiler error will come with this, sir? No. Integer objects are allowed. What is the reason for allowing these integer objects? The reason here is, again, if you go to this API documentation and search for integer. You have to find the integer class. Predefined integer is a wrapper class and it's a predefined class in Java. And this one also has a comparable. String class also has a comparable interface. String class is also implementing the comparable interface, and integer object is also implementing the comparable interface. But if I try to search for something known as string buffer, okay, if I search for string buffer, is it implementing the comparable? No, string buffer is not implementing the comparable. So guys, the thing that I wanted to explain here is, so whatever the objects that you want to give here, okay, whatever the objects that you want to insert here, that may be integer objects or string objects, but you cannot give, but you cannot insert string buffer here. Okay, you should not be inserting the string buffer here. If you try to insert this string buffer objects like this, it will not work, because string buffer class in the Java documentation is not implementing the comparable interface. Okay, all the classes which are implementing the comparable interface, those are only allowed here for sorting purpose. Okay, other things like string buffer etc. will not be sorted this. Okay, string buffer, Varun, let's give these three things and see whether this thing is working or not. You will get a compiler error, runtime error, guys. Okay, you see, cannot cast to comparable. So since string buffer class is by default not implementing the comparable interface, that's why we are getting a compiler error here. In place of this, if you give integer objects, it will work, because integer wrapper class is Java API. Okay, Java API is implementing which interface? Comparable interface. So that is another rule, guys. Okay, comparable interface should be implemented by the classes of these objects that you are inserting here. Since integer class in Java is implementing the comparable interface, those are comparable here. You see, it will work. And if you give the string objects or string also, same thing. It's implementing the comparable interface. Okay, it will also work. String objects will also work, because string class is implementing the comparable interface in Java. Okay, so this is another rule, guys. Okay, this is another rule you have to keep in mind as part of research. Okay, it's working. So like that. Fine. Next thing. Null insertion is not allowed. Okay, if you try to insert null, for example, you have added three string objects. Now if you try to add some null here. Okay, wherever if you try to add null here, you'll get a null pointer exception. Earlier it was working. Now if I run this after adding null, you'll get a null pointer exception. You cannot add null into the tree set. Okay, null cannot be added into the tree set, guys. That is another thing that you have to remember as for the tree set. So these are all the things. These are all the rules and regulations of the tree set, guys. Okay, duplicates are not allowed. If you try to add the duplicates, compiler error will not come, but they will not be really inserted into the tree set. Okay, second thing is, all the objects that are inserted into the tree set will be sorted, okay, according to the, by default they will be sorted according to the default sorting order. For integers, ascending order will be the default sorting order. For all string objects, that will be the alphabetical order will be the default sorting order. Customized sorting order I'll explain soon. Okay, in the same video itself I am going to explain the customized sorting order. Okay, it will take some time. Fine. Heterogeneous objects are not allowed. If you try to add some heterogeneous objects for this particular tree set, the sorting will not be possible. That's why heterogeneous objects cannot be added. Okay, if you try to add them, tree set will accept, but when you run the heterogeneous objects using the tree set, in the runtime you will get an exception. Okay, and next thing is, all the objects that you are inserting into the tree set, okay, their classes should implement comparable interface. For example, string buffer, which is in Java, is not implementing the comparable interface. If you try to add this string buffer objects into the tree set, you'll get the runtime exception. Okay, when you run the program, you'll get the runtime exception. Fine. Finally, null insertion is not allowed. Okay, so if you try to add null anywhere in the tree set, you'll get null pointer exception. So these are the few things that you have to know about the tree set, guys. Okay, Next thing here is, already explained about the default sorting order. Okay, for default sorting order, empty tree set is required. The constructor of the tree set should be empty. Okay, for default sorting order. So if you keep this while creating the object, if you keep this tree set constructor empty, then if you insert some integer objects, they will be sorted in ascending order. If you insert some string objects, they will be sorted in alphabetical order. Okay, so that is the default sorting order which I already covered. Next thing is, how this is happening then? How the tree set is able to sort these things? We have to know this thing, guys. Okay, we have to know how the tree set is internally sorting this integers into the ascending order and string objects into the alphabetical order. How these things are sorted by the tree set internally, that we need to understand now. Let me explain. So TreeSet internally uses a method known as compareTo method. Okay, there is a method known as internally. This is not external, guys. Okay, you have to understand internal. I'm only talking. This is not visible. So when you say TreeSet T is equal to new TreeSet, and when you say default sorting order will be there. This is the default sorting order. Okay, when default sorting order is being done. Okay, when you say t dot add Arun, Varun, Tarun and all the stuff, and when you print it, okay, when you print this program, otherwise we'll take another one, guys. 9 integer objects, let's take. Okay, so some 3, some 7, here 1, 25, 8. Then let's take something like 13. Then finally, let's take 5. Okay, these are the different integer objects we are adding into the tree set. While inserting, are these integer objects in any ascending order? No. But when you run this and when you print this tree set, they are being stored inside the tree set in the form of ascending order only, because here tree set is empty constructor here, which actually follows default sorting order. Default sorting order for the integer objects is ascending order. When I run this, I'll get the ascending order, right? All the objects will be inserted in ascending. You see, least number has come first and the greatest number has come last. This is ascending order. Fine. But how this is happening internally? How tree set is able to sort this integer objects into the ascending order? Okay, internally. The answer is, internally this add method, when add method is called, it will actually call this compareTo method. Okay, compareTo method belongs to which interface? Comparable. There is an interface known as comparable interface. Okay, I think I have listed down that particular thing in the collections framework. Let's see. Yeah, comparable interface. Okay, so there is an interface known as comparable interface, and it has a predefined method known as compareTo method. Okay, TreeSet is internally calling this compareTo method for sorting this integer objects. compareTo method is a predefined method of the comparable interface. Okay, so fine, that's good. So let's comment out all this part from here to here, and let's try to implement this compareTo method. Okay, so compareTo method is internally used by the tree set, right? It's not visible, but let me make it visible for you. Okay, so I commented out all this program. Now I'm going to use compareTo method. So if I say system.out.println, okay, I have to take something here. Before this, I have to say integer a is equal to some 3, integer b is equal to some 5. System.out.println a dot compareTo b. If I write something like this, okay, if I say write something like this, what will happen? How this compareTo method will work? So you have to know something here, guys. Okay, so compareTo has some return type called int. So So this, when you print this a dot compare to, when you hover the mouse on compare to, it will return you some int. Okay, some int that may be a positive number, negative number, or zero. Okay, this int value returned by this compare to will be either positive number, negative number, or zero. Okay, so here when I say here a is coming before b, okay, a is coming before b, so what will be printed, guys? So here let's run this, right click run as job application. So don't have to understand what exactly will be the output, guys. So some negative value one is coming, okay, negative value is coming, okay, when a is smaller than this b, then you are getting minus one. Okay, fine. When I say a dot compare to, sorry, b dot, okay, b dot compare to a, then I'll get a positive value, guys. Some positive value I'm going to get. Okay, right click, run as job application. Okay, like this kind of technology is being used by this compare to, guys. Internally this TreeSet is calling this compare to. If it gets negative value, it will do something. It will get some positive value, it will do something like that. Okay, if this method, when you say t dot add, it will, this value will be added, it will be compared with some other value. Okay, so that that will be done with the help of, internally done with the help of compare to method. Okay, the compare to method will actually compare it. If it gets some negative value, it will do something. If it gets some positive value, it will do something. Okay, you don't have to understand the logic. Okay, so simply you are going to get the negative value, positive value, and also, and what if all these two values are same? It will return you zero also. Okay, a dot compare to, you don't have to write again, simply remove these things. You'll get the value as zero, guys, when both are equal, when a and b are equal, and you are comparing using the compare to method of the comparable interface. Okay, which is actually done by the TreeSet internally when this objects are getting inserted. Okay, so it will return zero. Okay, zero will be returned to this add method. Okay, zero will be returned to this add method, which is calling this compare to. So based on that negative value or positive value or zero, the sorting is going to happen internally. Okay, this thing you have to understand, guys. This thing you need to understand because of internally using the compare to method of the comparable interface, the sorting is happening in the default sorting order way. Okay, so that thing only you need to understand. You don't have to dig much deeper. Okay, that's not required for us. You don't have to understand in detail, guys, how the minus one will be taken into consideration and all those stuff. Okay, so finally only we'll use something, we'll create an object for the TreeSet and insert objects, integer objects, and TreeSet will take care of the sorting order. By internally what's happening, it's calling the compare to of the comparable interface, okay, of the comparable interface, and because of that sorting is happening. That's one of the reason, guys. That's one of the reason. If you say new string buffer, okay, new string buffer of Arun, will this work? No, string buffer is not implementing the comparable interface, so hence this compare to method cannot be called. That's why all the classes in Java which are implementing the comparable interface, for them only sorting is possible. That's why new string buffer is not allowed. Only integer objects or string objects are allowed. String class in Java and integer wrapper class in Java both actually implement the comparable interface, which have this compare to method, because of the sorting is possible. Otherwise, if you say new string buffer and all, if you try to add such kind of objects, you are going to get a runtime error, right? Runtime exception you are going to get. That's the reason, guys. Okay, that's the reason you have to understand this internal concept. Fine, let's move ahead, guys. That is enough. Okay, that's enough. Next thing here is now, so far what we did, guys, only up to default sorting order I explained, right? Now I am going to explain how to do customized sorting order with the help of TreeSet. Okay, so what are the benefits of customized sorting order? In default sorting order, only two things are there. One is ascending order for integer objects and alphabetical order for the string objects. But if I want descending order, can I use default sort order? No, it's not possible, right? I have to implement something known as customized sorting order. I have to implement, okay, customized sorting order I have to implement with the TreeSet. For that, this constructor should not be empty. Okay, this TreeSet constructor, if it is empty, it is default sorting order. Okay, if it is not empty, then we are going to use customized sorting order. So how to use a customized sorting order? Okay, for that we have to focus on something known as comparator interface. There is an interface known as comparator interface. Again, if you go to the collections framework under the sorting, you have the along with this comparable, which is actually meant for the default sorting order, which is internally taken care by the TreeSet as part of the default sorting order. One of the predefined methods of the comparable is compareTo method, okay, which is internally taken care for sorting of the default sorting order of the TreeSet, right? Now we are talking about the customized sorting order, which is being taken care by the comparator, okay? For this comparator to be implemented, we have to focus on comparator, guys, okay? We have to use comparator for getting the customized sorting. How to do that? Here, no internal working, okay? Coming to the comparable, it is internally the objects are getting sorted, right? With the help of the compareTo method of the comparable interface. But here, explicitly, we have to use a comparator. For customized sorting, we have to explicitly use this comparator interface. How to explicitly use? For this, we have to create another class, guys, okay? Create anything, okay? Create any class. Say, you can even say class A, okay? Give any name you want, okay? Click on finish. After finishing, say implements, okay? Which interface we have to implement, guys? For customized sorting, which interface we have to implement? Comparator interface we have to implement. So comparator you have to say, okay? Comparator. Over the mouse, import this comparator interface from which package? Java.util package. And again, when you implement that, all the unimplemented methods of this comparator has to be implemented inside this class, because class is implementing this interface. If there are any unimplemented methods without anybody, you know about the interfaces, right? So if this in the interface, only the methods without any definition will be there. Since this particular class is implementing this interface, all the methods which doesn't have any body inside this comparator interface has to be implemented here. That's the reason we are getting a compiler error here. So simply what we are going to do is hover the mouse on this class and select add unimplemented methods. You see, whatever this compare method belongs to which interface? Comparator interface, which is just defined inside the comparator interface. Now, since class is implementing this comparator, okay, we have to implement. So the definition and the body will be there here, okay? The definition that was specified in the comparator is like compare object one, object two, okay? So we have to return something. So let's auto-generate the code, so no need to worry much, right? So once you do this, okay, what you have to do is, this is enough, guys. You have to create a class and implement a comparator interface. And when you implement the comparator interface, it's predefined method, that is compare method, has to be implemented by the class which is implementing the comparator interface. Up to that, we did, okay? We have auto generated the code for the compare method of the comparator interface after implementing by this class. Up to that, it is enough, guys. Now let's go to demo class. And here, if you keep this constructor empty, what will happen? Default sorting order will be implemented on these objects. But what if I provide some object for this class A, new class A, I will say, okay? Here, class A is implementing which interface? Comparator interface. That's why I'm saying new class A. Okay, new class A. I have to pass this object of the class A, which is implementing the comparator interface. Okay, so then customized sorting will start, guys. Okay, so here now this will allow the customized sorting. Okay, customized sorting. But we have to write some logic inside this. Okay, inside this compare method of this comparator interface. I have to write a logic, okay, for sorting. For example, if I write, I'll remove the return, okay? So here, these are integer objects, but I am getting them in the form of objects here, okay? So what I'm going to do here is, this object, I'll typecast into the integer again, okay? Integer, integer i1 is equal to, okay? I object, I will say otherwise. I one also you can say, not a problem. Okay. Is equal to, I'll typecast. This O1 I will typecast. Okay. Here. Like this. I'm just converting this object into the integer. That's it. Okay. Second thing, integer. Or else you can typecast like first, you can typecast integer. You have to typecast this object into the integer type. Okay. So I'll save into the I2. Second integer object value, okay? So hover the mouse, create local variable, integer will come. Now I can compare, okay? So the previous topic I explained about one of the method of this comparable interface, right? What is that method, guys? CompareTo method. What it will do? It will compare one object with another object for sorting purpose. I'll do the same thing, guys, okay? I'll say return i1 dot compare to, compare to of I2. Okay, I'm comparing this I1 with I2. That's it. What will happen, guys? This is same as the default sorting order. Whatever that default sorting will default sorting order, if you don't specify this thing in the constructor, whatever the default sorting order will be done here, this will be calling the which method? Compare to method of the comparable interface. Okay, comparable interface. The same thing is happening here also. You are retaining the same thing. So if you do the same thing, if you implement the same logic here, the default sorting order actually implements, you'll get the same output. That is, after implementing this customized sorting order also, okay, after implementing this customized sorting order also, all these objects will be inserted in ascending order only, because still the logic is it was internal, I just made it external, but same logic is there. This used to be the internal logic of this default sorting order, which I made it external in the customized sorting order. That's it, nothing more. Okay, if I run this code, right click run as Java application, I will get the same ascending order. You see, ascending order is there, but can I make it descending, guys? Is it possible to make this particular order to descending? Yes, we have to change this logic inside this compare method of this comparator interface. Okay, how to do that? Instead of saying I1 dot compare dot I2, I have to say I2 dot reverse way, I2 dot compare dot I1. With this simple change in the logic, the things will change, guys. If I run this code, right click run as Java application, you see descending order we got. Did we get this descending order with the default sorting order earlier? No. Now I am getting it because I just changed the customized sorting. This is customization, guys. I have customized the sorting. If I say I1 dot compared to I2, I will get the ascending order. If I say I2 dot compared to dot I1, I will get the descending order. So I am able to customize. This is known as customization of the sorting. Okay, one of the customization of the sorting. So what about the, these are integer objects, right? These are the integer objects. Fine, let's do more customization for the sorting order here. Okay, so all the integer objects ascending order is done. If I say object one dot compare object one dot compared to object two in this compare logic, right? When I say descending order, I have to give something like, I have to customize this compare method by saying I2 dot compare to dot I1. That will actually customize this in a descending order like this. Next thing here is I want the objects to be inserted only in the insertion order. Okay, so I want to get the same insertion order here. Okay, here 9 is there, 3 is there, then 7 is there. I want to get the same insertion order here, 9, 3, 7, I want to print. Then guys, okay, then you have to simply return some positive value. Okay, let's return some positive value, whatever it is, whatever the objects you send, simply return the positive value and let's run it. What will happen? Let's see. You see, the same insertion order is reserved. Okay, if you want the tree set to reserve the insertion order, this customization sorting, you have to simply return plus one irrespective of these objects. Okay, that has been passed to this compare method. You don't have to do anything, simply return plus one, whatever the output is there, you have to return minus plus one. Okay, what if I want the reverse of this insertion order? I want 5 first, then 16. Here we got 9, 3, 7. Instead, I want to get 5, 16, 13, 8, 25, 1, 7, 3, 9, like that. Okay, for that simply you say minus one. Okay, return minus one. If I run this, I'll get the reverse order, reverse insertion order I'm going to get. You see, reverse. So 5 was inserted last, I'm getting it first. 16 was last but one, second position, like that. Okay, so this is another way. Now this is how, guys, we can customize the sorting order. Okay, by using what? By using what customization of the sorting order is possible in TreeSet? We have to go with the comparator interface. Okay, we have to create a class, any class which implements this comparator interface, so that you can implement this compare method of this comparator interface. Inside that compare method of this comparator interface, you are going to write the logic. Okay, logic depends. If you want ascending order, you will go with the compare to method of this comparable again. Okay, descending order also compare to method of the comparable. If you want same insertion order, you have to return plus one. If you want a reverse insertion order, you have to return minus one. Okay, next, what next? Same thing you can apply for the string objects also, guys. Okay, same thing you can apply for the string objects. Instead of this objects, if I say t dot add of, I'll say Varun, t dot add of Arun, t dot add of Tarun. Okay, like this. If I give something like this, three objects are there. Okay, and I have the customization. Customize sorting is also there. Now here I will say return I1 dot compare to I2. I1 dot compare to I2. If I give something like this, what will happen, guys? Default sorting order. This is the logic of the default sorting order, right? This is the logic of the default sorting order. Here this one will be compared with this one, something like that. Okay, default sorting order. In default sorting order, it uses the compare to method internally. Here we have explicitly provided. That's the only thing. Customization is done. That's it. Okay, we'll get in the alphabetical order. Okay, we'll get the results in the alphabetical order now. Okay, let's save it and run it. You'll get the result in alphabetical order. Okay, so there's something wrong here. Sorry, I did something mistake. As you can see here, we got the objects. I typecast it into integer here. Here these objects are string objects, right? These are the string objects. I have to say string here. Okay, I have to typecast using string now. Then only I can compare. String. String. Okay. So now let's see. Now let's run this. Right click run as Java application. You see, sorted. They got sorted in ascending alphabetical order. I want the reverse of this alphabetical order. What I have to do, guys? The same thing that we did for the integer objects. That is, here instead of I1, I will say I2. Instead of I2, I will say I1. That's the only difference. It will give you the reverse of the alphabetical order. Okay, last will Arun, Tarun, Varun. Okay, earlier Arun, Tarun, Varun was there. Now Varun, Tarun, Arun is there. Okay, same things you can apply, guys. Okay, same logic. If you say return plus one, what will happen, guys? If you say return plus one, what will happen? The same insertion order will be preserved. First Varun, Arun, Tarun will print out now. Okay, right click run as Java application. Varun, Arun, Tarun. If I give return minus one, what will be done? Reverse of this insertion order. That is, Tarun will come first, then Arun will come, then Varun will come. Right click run as Java application. Tarun, Arun, Varun. Reverse of the insertion order will be there. So this is how, guys, we can customize the sorting order with the help of TreeSet by using the comparator interface and its method known as compare method. Okay, we have to implement the compare method of this comparator interface explicitly, okay, not internal, explicitly, to customize the sorting order. And at the same time, we have to change the constructor. TreeSet constructor should be different here. Okay, it should have some class which is implementing the comparator interface. Okay, like this. Coming to the comparable interface, it is internal. Okay, it is internal. If in case of default sorting order, if you don't provide any empty tree set here, it will be default sorting order, and internally this program is using the compare to method of this comparable interface. Okay, this is for default sorting order, and this is for which order, guys? This is for customized sorting order. You have to know the difference between comparable and comparator. Okay, comparable for default sorting order, which is used internally only. Comparator for customized sorting order, which you have to explicitly mention in the programs. Okay, that is the differences between the comparable and comparator. Okay, for sorting purpose in the case of tree set. Now, guys, sorting wise, we are done with the tree set, guys. We have learned a lot about the tree set so far, but there are few things that are left. That is, this tree set is a child class of the navigable set and is a grandchild class of the sorted set. That means all the predefined methods of the sorted set and all the predefined methods of this navigable set can be utilized by this tree set. Okay, let's do that. So for that, I'll go back, guys. Okay, I'll remove this. I'll make this for avoiding the confusions. What I'm going to do is I'll go with the default sorting order. Okay, I'll go with the default sorting order, and I'll not require this class now. I'll delete this. Sorry. Don't save. Delete. I only have this demo class, and it is a normal tree set. If you insert something like this, tree dot add of, okay, some nine. If I say t dot add of integer objects, I'm inserting guys three. T dot add of six. T dot add of Okay, t dot add of 1, t dot add of 13 or 25, t dot add of 13, t dot add of 8, t dot add of 2. Okay, like this different integer objects I inserted so far. Okay, what will happen when I print it, guys? This is a default sorting order. Empty tree set is there. All the objects, integer objects, will be stored in the tree set in the which order? Default sorting order for the integer objects is ascending order. So ascending order will come as the output. Okay, let's get the ascending order as output first. 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, 9, 13, 25. Ascending order is done. Now let's start implementing the predefined methods of the sorted set. Okay, on such kind of sorted order, let's try to implement this predefined methods of the sorted set. So let's start using the first method. Okay, so system.out.println t dot, on the tree set I am saying first, I'm calling the first method of the, this first method belongs to which interface? Sorted set interface. Okay, I'm utilizing that in the with the tree set, because tree set is a grandchild of the sorted set interface. I can use it. Okay, I can call this first method using the object of the tree set. Okay, so what will be the result, guys? After sorting, whatever the first object is there, that will be result. That means here this has to be sorted like this. After sorting, what is the first object here, guys? 1. So here 1 should be printed. Okay, that is the purpose, guys. After sorting, it will consider that first. So 1. Next one. Similar method, last is there. Okay, very easy methods, guys. T dot last. After sorting, what is the last object? After, this is a sorted. This is a sorted, right? After sorting, this is the thing. In alphabetical order, it got sorted. And after sorting, what is the last object? 25. 25 will be printed here. Right click, run as Java application. You see, 25 got printed. Let's go to the next method. Okay, let's go to the next method, that is headset. System.out.println t dot headset. If I give some number like, nine, what will happen, guys? T dot headset, all the objects after sorting before 9, whatever are coming, that is 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, that will be printed, guys. T dot headset of 9 means before 9, how many objects are there? 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. Okay, those should be printed. So right click, run as Java application. You see, before 9, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. So 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. This is the purpose of the headset. It will retrieve all the objects after sorting, all the objects which come before the 9. Okay, so 1, I don't have to print the output, you understood it. Okay, system.out.println. If I say another method is there, that is tail set. Okay, tail set. T dot tail set. So I give the same 9. Okay, for headset also I gave 9. But what happened with the headset? Less than 9, whatever the objects are there, they got printed here. Right? But coming to the tail set, okay, here less than 9. Okay, simply I will write a comment as less than 9. Less than 9, after sorting, whatever the objects that are less than 9, that will be printed. Okay, but coming to the tail set, is an opposite of the headset, guys. It is greater than or equal to 9 also. Okay, here equal to is not there with headset, but coming to the tail set, equal to is also there, greater than or equal to 9. That means 9 is there, starting from 9, and then greater than 9, that is 9, 13, 25 should be printed. Greater than or equal to 9, that is 9, 13, 25. Let's run this. 9, 13, 25. Okay, before 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. Now 9, 13, 25, greater than or equal to 9. That's how the tail set works. Then we have subset. System.out.println t dot subset of, okay, subset of 2 and 9. if you, you have to give two objects, guys. Okay, how this logic works? Greater than or equal to 2 and less than 9. This is how it works. Okay, greater than or equal to 2 and less than 9. So greater than or equal to 2, 2 will be retrieved, then 3, 6, 8, but less than 9, not equal to 9. Up to 2, 3, 6, 8 only will be retrieved, guys. Okay, 2, 3, 6, 8. Let's see that whether we get 2, 3, 6, 8 in the output or not. 2, 3, 6, 8 got printed. So this is how this predefined methods of the sorted set will work. The purpose of the sorted set predefined methods is to retrieve the objects. Okay, based on our requirement, we can retrieve the objects. Either we can retrieve the first sorted object, either we can retrieve the last sorted object. Okay, like that. Okay, now we are done with the predefined methods of the sorted set. Now I'm going to demonstrate the predefined methods of the navigable set, because child class TreeSet is a child class of navigable set. So all the predefined methods of the navigable set can be utilized by this TreeSet. So what I will do here is I will say system.out.println, and I will just put a line here, okay, just for separation. Again, I'll print the T. If I print T, all the ascending order objects will be retrieved, right? So right click run as Java application. Again, we'll get the same output. Initially, whatever the output we got, the same output we'll get. That is 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. Ascending order, the objects will be retrieved. Fine. Printed. Now, let's, on this particular set, let's start using this predefined methods of the navigable set. Let's start with the lower, guys. Okay? Lower. So, if you remember, navigable set has some specific methods which are related to navigation purpose. Okay? So, one requirement I want to ask you, that is, I want to get this only 8. Okay? I want to retrieve only 8 from this sorted set, sorted objects. Okay? These are the sorted objects, right? These are sorted by the tree set. I want to only get this 8 object. What to do, guys? Can I retrieve this object 8 using any of these methods of this sorted set interface? It's not possible. Only first and last are possible, but remaining, they will be coming in groups like this. Okay, only first objects, last object, it is possible, but in between objects, can I navigate and get this object in between using the predefined methods of this sorted set interface? It's not possible. Only first and last of the sorted set can we get. Other three methods will actually retrieve the set of objects, not single objects. But if I have a requirement where I want to retrieve only this 8, what I have to do? For that, we have to navigate to 9 and then retrieve this 8. Okay, we have to navigate using the navigation methods which are there in the navigable set interface and retrieve this 8. Let me explain. Okay, so by using this method known as lower, let's go with the lower, guys. Okay, system.out.println, I will say something like this: system.out.println t dot lower of object. This object I will give as 9, guys. Okay, here I am saying to this lower method is navigate to this 9. Okay, I have navigated to this 9. After navigating, find the greatest first. It's kind of confusing, guys, but let's understand. Okay, t dot lower of 9. So I am saying that go to 9 and all the objects should be, and search for all the objects, navigate through all the objects which are less than 9. Lower of 9 means it should be less than 9, right? These are all the things. 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. How many objects are there which are lower than 9? 5 objects. Out of all these things, retrieve the greatest object. Okay? First of all, it should be less than 9. Okay? All the objects which are less than 9 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. These are the different objects which are less than 9. And find the greatest. And then find the greatest. First, find all the objects which are less than 9 using this lower method. If you say lower of 9, it will find all the integer objects which are lower than 9. That is 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. Out of all these integer objects which are lower than 9, find the greatest. What is the greatest out of this 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, guys? 8. So it will return. It will print 8, guys. Now I'm getting the value as 8. This is how we have to use the lower method, okay, of the navigable set for navigation purpose. You got the output as 8, okay, fine. Then let's go with another navigation method, that is opposite of the lower is higher, okay. Let's go with that. System.out.println t dot higher of 9, if I say 9, okay, what does this mean? I'm asking to find all the objects which are greater than 9. Here greater than 9, what are the different objects which are greater than 9, guys? After sorting, greater than 9 is 39 25. In that find the list, okay, in the greater than 9 objects, that is 39 25, which is the list number 13. After 9 we are navigating to 13. With the help of 9 we are navigating to 13 with this logic, okay. Like this it will work fine. Is also done. So did I run? Yeah, let me run this. Right click, run as job application. You'll get the output as 13. Okay, whatever the object we want to retrieve, we are able to navigate to that part using this navigation methods of the navigable interface and retrieve them, okay, using this kind of logics. Next thing is we have something known as floor, okay. Floor, system.out.println t dot floor of 9. This is also similar to lower case, but there is a class, okay, that is less than or equal to 9, okay, and find the greatest. This is the only logic, and find the greatest. Here less than 9, but here floor, for lower it is less than 9, but floor it is less than or equal to 9. That means less than or equal to 9, okay. So 9 and less than 9, that is 1 2 3 6 8 9 are there. How many are there? 6 objects have been retrieved, and out of all the 6 we have to find the greatest. 1 2 3 6 8 9, which is greatest? 9 is greatest, so output will be 9, okay. Right click, run as job application. 9 will be out. What if I give something like 10? Okay, it will be like less than or equal to 10. Do you have the 10 object here? No, but still it will work, okay. So it will check for the objects which are less than or equal to 10. Is there any 10 here in this sorted objects? No, 10 is not there, but less than or equal to 10, equal to is not there, but less than 10 is there. So it will consider 1 2 3 6 8 9, out of which is greatest. Out of this list values, which is greatest? List of 10 values, which is greatest? 9 is greatest. So again 9 will be printed, guys, okay. Right click, run as job application. 9 will be printed. Similarly, an opposite method also there for floor, that is ceiling, okay. Ceiling, system.out.println t dot ceiling of, if I give something like 9, what will be the result? Internal logic will be something like this: greater than or equal to 10. Sorry, 9 I have given, right? Greater than or equal to 9. Okay, it works similar to higher, that is greater than 9, but here equal to is addition. And find the list of the found objects we have to find. Okay, so greater than or equal to 9, and find the list. Greater than or equal to 9, that means 9, greater than 9 is 13, then 25. These are the 3 objects that will be retrieved. Out of these 3 objects, we have to find the list. What is the list out of this 9, 13, 25? 9. So 9 will be printed. Right click, run as job application, okay. 9 is output. What if I give 10 here? So here greater than or equal to 10 will be there, and we have to find the list. So greater than or equal to 10, is 10 there here? No. Greater than 10 is 1325. Out of 1325, which is the list one? 13. So 13 will be printed. You'll get the output as 13. Right click, run as job application. Output will be 13. Next thing, these are the navigation methods, guys. Lower, higher, floor, and ceiling are the navigation methods, okay. So these are specific only to the navigable set, which are not there in the sorted set, okay. If you want to navigate somewhere and retrieve only specific elements, you have to use any of these 4 navigation methods of this navigable set, okay. And remaining things we have is, let's do with this descending set, okay. Straightforward methods, guys. That is system.out.println, if I said t dot descending set. So by default, the sorting order will be ascending, right? Sorting order will be ascending. I can convert into descending with the help of this descending set method directly. Okay. Here, ascending order is 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, 9, 13, 25. Descending order is 25, 13, 9, 8, 6, 3, 2, 1. That is possible with the help of descending set. Okay. So right click, run as job application. You see, descending order. All the objects got printed in descending order now. Okay. Because of this method. Fine. So descending set is also done. Next thing here is poll first and poll last. So if I say poll first, what will happen? T dot poll. I'll remove this, guys. Okay. I'll remove this descending so that it will be confusing. What I will do is again, I will print T. Okay. Here. System dot out dot println. I'll get the ascending order again. Okay. So run it. Right click, run as Java application. After ascending, this is the original ascending order we got here. Okay. Now I'm going to apply poll first and poll last on this ascending order. System.out.println. If I say t dot poll. Poll first. Okay, what will happen here, guys? Okay. If I say t dot poll first. When these are sorted, when these objects, all these integer objects are sorted in inserting order, what is the first object, guys? 1. Okay, 1 will be retrieved. Poll first will retrieve this 1. At same time, it will remove the 1 from this tree set. 1 will be removed from the tree set, guys. After polling, if you print the tree set, the 1 will not be there. Okay, here 1 will be retrieved from the tree set, but 1 will not be there. The first object after starting will be retrieved. That is, 1 will be retrieved and printed here by the poll first. But after this poll first, if you print the complete T again, then 1 will not be there in that list. Okay, fine. Let's run this. Right click, run as job application. So out of this complete tree set objects, poll first has printed this 1, has retrieved this 1 from this. At same time, it has removed the 1 from the complete tree set. Now 1 is not there in this tree set. You see, only 2, 3, 6, 8, 9, 13, 25 is there. That is actually poll first. Similarly, another method is there, that is poll last, which works reversely. Okay. System.out.println. Last will be removed. Okay. Here poll first will remove the first object of the sorted. Then poll last will remove the last object. So that means poll last, out of the remaining objects inside the tree set, the last object is 25. After sorting, last object is 25. Poll last will retrieve this 25 and print it here. println will print the object that is retrieved by this poll last. That is, 25 will be retrieved by this poll last and will be printed by this println here. Okay, here 25 will be printed. At same time, poll last will remove this 25 from the tree set. So if I try to print the tree set again after poll last, 25 will not be there in the list, guys. Okay, 25 will not be there in the tree set. So run it. 25 is not there in the tree set. Only 2, 3, 6, 8, 9, 13 are there. Poll first has removed the 1 from the tree set and poll last has removed the 25 from the tree set. And also it is retrieved at the same time. Okay, here 1 got retrieved. So these are all the predefined methods of the navigable set, guys. Okay, these are for the navigation purpose and these are for other purposes. Okay. So guys, hope you understood the tree set. Okay, hope you understood the tree set. Last but not least, you can even add the generics here, guys. For example, if you only want to add the integer objects, simply add the generic here. Generic concepts I will explain in the upcoming videos in a detailed way. Like this, you can add the generics. Okay, already explained about the generics as part of the array list and other things of this collections framework videos. Okay, you can refer to them if you want to understand what exactly the generics are up to this mark. Okay, if you mention this generic here, only integer objects are allowed. To try to add any string objects, it will give compiler errors. Okay, fine. If you want to add any string objects here, you have to provide string here. Okay, if you want add heterogeneous objects, you have to provide object here. Okay, in place of this generic, you have to add the object class or integer class or string object class or any other wrapper class based on the type of objects you want to add. Okay, that's all about the generics. So guys, that's all about the tree set. We are done with the tree set. So far I explained this collection as part of the collection interface. I already covered all these classes. Okay, all these things are covered as part of the list interface and its child classes are covered already in the previous videos. Now coming to the set also, I completed everything. That is set interface and its child classes and interfaces and classes. Everything is covered as part of the set. So do I have to cover the queue? Do I have to cover the queue? No, guys, I'm not going to cover queue because queue is not that much used as part of the tester concept or beginner way of understanding the things. Queue is not required to understand. Okay, so I'm not going to cover queue in my videos. So directly I'm going to jump to the map interface. I'm going to jump into the map interface. So this is another first off is done, guys. Now, okay, I completed the first off, like list interface and its child classes I completed, and set interface and its child class and interface also completed, and queue is not required to learn. So this first off is completed. First off is completed under the collections framework. We are left with the second part, that is map interface and its child classes or interfaces. Okay, there are many child classes and interfaces for this map, which I am going to cover in the coming videos. I'm going to start the next video session. I'm going to start with the map interface first. This particular thing, map interface first. Then I will go with the upcoming videos. I will go with the its child classes and interfaces. Okay, one by one. So these are the different things I'm going to cover next. And coming to the other, enumeration is covered as part of one of the collection, and iterator is also covered. List iterator is also covered. Sorting wise, comparable and comparator also covered. Okay, and collections class a bit covered, and arrays class I didn't cover. Okay, these two things are left. Okay, collections class and arrays I need to cover, which I will be doing after completing the map. Okay, I'll be covering this the remaining utility classes like collections and arrays in detail after completing the map interface and its child classes and interfaces. Okay, which I'll be starting next. So guys, in the next video session I'll start with the map interface. That's the plan, guys. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.